Okay friends, for same, let we continue about product. Same like the previous video, employee video, we can add the product, and this is performed by admin zone only. Before we going for adding new product in our table, let we move to PDET table. Product detail is the name of this table. I'm just going to open table definition by right click. You can see over here, it's a product description table is given with the proper attributes, or we can say field. Product ID integer, it is a primary key. Product type, it is a wearcare, where we can define the product type like confectionery item. Then after we are taking about bathing shop, then electronic products, and it's a type of product. Next is product company, where we are mentioning the product company name like Samsung, iPhone, Apple, Xiaomi, as well as Dairy Milk, or the company that is related with the product that we are mentioning. Then we move to the next field, that is product FNM. The meaning of FNM means product full name, where we have to describe the product full name with the size. In this project, I would like to mention, if in this dummy entry we are having some soap, tea, and there are so many different items like Dairy Milk, Silk, that's a very popular product all over the world. We are mentioning the size of product also, that we will look when we will just show the data. This is product description. You want to just make it that ingredients that we are using in this particular product, or description, something like that, that you want to mention this particular product, it will be available in product description. Then P price means the product price. It will be again a numerical data with the point. If any product price is 10.32 rupees 32 paise, or in decimal, so we can mention it by decimal. And the next one is, the last is product quantity. The product quantity that available with admin or the consumer shop that we are developed this project under it. Let me take a look about product tables dummy records. We are moving to show table data by right click on the table. Yes friends, as you know very well, we previously discussed about it. There are some records are there that you can see with this highlighting. Product ID 1, that's a type of product is bathing shop. The company is ITC. We will aloe vera 100 gram. This is the particular size of the product that we are mentioning. The same thing, bathing shop is there. Medimix is a company. The soap name is Sandal, and the size weight is 75 grams. It is a description that you can mention with your own. This price is 40 rupees and 55 quantity is available. Then bathing shop, again PNG, Lux Cooling Mint 54 grams. The price is 55 rupees and it's a zero quantity available. If we want to increase the quantity, we can make it, move it to 12, and this table is there. Fine friends, as per we earlier discussed about the employee adding table, we already prepared the product menu. Into the product, insert, update, delete is there. When I click on it, it is easily showing by you guys. When I click on it, you can understand, dim acts as new product main. It means I already prepare one form, the name is product main. Look at the right side of the screen where my mouse is moving, this is product main form is there. If we move ahead, x.mdi parent equal to me, it means whenever that particular form will open, product main form will open, it will be always child form. And guys, you know very well, x.text at dynamic runtime, I'm changing the title of the text, that is now you open product main form, you are having all rights, means we can add the product, we can update the product price, we can delete the product. X.show, and the same x.windowState equal to form windowState.maximize, means whenever this form will load, it will be automatically maximized view. let me take a look about MDI parent, and then after this product main, I am double click on it, and it is same structure like employee heading that you learned from the previous video. Again, we are having some of the component like product ID. It is an auto number that you know very well in our database. You see it when I just show the sample data, show table data, and you can observe that one 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 up to 12 is there. So it is an auto ID. Auto ID, auto increment, that is the reason we are putting label 8 over here. Then after product type, you can compare this particular fields with my tools. Then company of the product, that is pcomp, that will be bind with this text box 2. Then product full name, that will be bind with text box 3. Yes, product description will be available here by this particular rich text box, or we can say that one multi-line text box. Then product price is there, product quantity is there, and search zone the product name wise. So guys, it is a very simple, same like employee heading form. In my previous video, you learn about how to add the employee. In this video, we learn how to add the product. In my form load event, I put it down all REC, all record, and radio button 1 dot visible false, means when I load this particular form, this all new product will, this radio button will not display. This is the reason that I am putting this radio button 1 dot visible equal to false. And if we are discussing about all record, this is a subroutine that we are mentioning this particular highlighted part. Let me understand the code of this. Connection is open. Before they start the connection, you know very well, import system.data, import system.data.sql client is our library for connection SQL with this vb.net project by ado.net architecture. Connection we already taken as general. Then dim DA means data adapter as new SQL data adapter, and we are putting select query, select star from PDET. It means clearly understand that one, this all 1 to 12 product will adopt by this adapter, because it is a name as DA SQL data adapter. It adapt all the record. Then after, we declare the data set. The data set is having declaration like that, dim ds as new data set. Then data adapter will fill all the 12 records to the data set. For confirmation, we put it down product detail table. Last but not least, we want to show this all 12 records in a data grid view, guys. So this data grid view 1 dot data source equal to ds dot tables, and into the bracket we are mentioning product detail as a table. Finally, we close the connection. So guys, whenever we will add new record, when we will update to any record, or when we delete any record, you can understand that one, this particular subroutine name all record will call. For this, let me move to the code. First of all, go to design. When I click on the add button, you can clearly understand it is a insert query by command, insert into table name. These are the fields name, and then after values. Whenever you put the values, please take care about the data types. Whenever your data type is particularly where care or alphabetical way, you have to take single inverted comma start, single inverted over, double inverted comma start, double inverted over, address operator start, address operator over. Then after, you put a text box 1 dot text. As you know that one, in particular this is a product type. When I click on the property, you can clearly understand this is text box 1. So it is very easy to understand, my friends, this is a data type. This particular data type is varchar. Varchar means alphabet, and whenever alphabet is there, it is single, single over, double, double over, address, address operator over, then after the tool, then after that, you know, variable, product company is a text data type, product full name is a text data type, product description is a text data type. So text box 1, 2, 3, 4 all is having single inverted, double inverted, address, address, and respective tools are there. But when we reach to product price, this is text box 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If we are moving to the design, I click on product price, I make it this property live, and you can understand this is text box 5. So let me scroll this something little over here. And yes, my friends, I am highlighting this particular part, and you can understand when any numerical data types will come, we have to take care about double inverted comma start, double inverted comma over, address operator start, address operator over, and then after text box 5 dot text. Same with product quantity. Product quantity is again a numerical data type, that you can consider this particular product quantity as a numerical data. That you know, my mouse is moving from top to bottom, this product price is also numeric. Due to that reason, we are taking this particular numerical data type, we are using text box 6, my friend. And for numerical data type, double inverted start, double inverted over, address operator start, address operator over, text box 6 dot text. And finally, as you know that one, CMD means a command class. When command class is execute as none query, you can insert new product, you can update the product, you can delete the product. When one record is inserted, then after I don't require the previous record, so I make it text box 1 dot clear, same 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 respectively, all text boxes will clear. And then after I put it text box 1 dot focus, means my cursor will be here. Then after cn dot close, means connection will close, and radio button 1 dot visible false. If we click on any data records, and that will be binded by data grid view, I will explain within this video after few minutes. After adding one record, you guys knows very well this thing, all record, this subroutine will take run so many times. This particular subroutine will use in my form load event, that you can see my mouse is moving on form load event. My form name is product main. Same like this, when we click on update, you know that this is a update query, and update query is having again cmd dot execute none query. But if you observe this thing very clearly, after connection close and validating, I use all record subroutine. So after updating, I have to move to my all record subroutine, and that all record subroutine will adapt all the records. Either I can add new record, either I update any record, or either I delete all the records. Now let me understand about that update query, because this is very important. If text box 1 dot text equal to empty, means if you want to update any record but you do not have a product ID or anything else, you cannot update the record. You can see my where query is there, where product ID equal to label 8 dot text, and you know very well my product ID is numerical form. So I started with double inverted comma start, double inverted over, address operator start, address operator over, and label 8 dot text is there, and I use my update query with SQL command. Update table name PDET, set product type equal to text box 1, that you can compare this particular sequence with the proper manner. Product type text box 1, product company text box 2, then product full name, that it will be text box 3. Yes guys, you can verify, you can compare. Product description, product description will be available in text box 4. Product price, it is text box 5. And last, product quantity, that is with textbooks 6, but primary key is very important for update or delete. So I put it down where clause, and into where clause product ID is our primary key. And once again execute none query will update the record, and update the record will connection close. And yes, if you want to update the record and your record will be not available, first you must select record from the data grid view that you want to update. Means it is a compulsion event, there a record that you want to update, it must select, it must have a primary key of product ID, and then you guys can update the record. This if condition will close by end if. This is a control statement, if and if, and then after I execute all record subroutine. Friends, now it's time to discuss about delete record. I double click on delete, same like the update, I put it down same condition guys, but my query is changed, that is delete from product detail. Please mention this thing, delete star asterisk not use product detail, where product ID equal to label 8.txt cn, it's a connection, cmd.execute none query, it will be commonly used for insert record, update record and delete record. This is a message box that I want to just show you, that is a delete record, and after my connection will close. And if you are not selecting any record to run it, you cannot delete the record. So it's an instruction, simple instruction that we are putting down. Please kindly click on the record from data grid view that you want to delete, and if all record. Yes students, yes my friends, the last but not least, it is very important, when I double click on it, this is a very important code for all of us. When we have to make it any record update and any record delete, it is very compulsory that we have to bind our records with our tools, and for tools we have to use this particular data grid view with this code. So let's understand this code. There is no connection, there is no adapter, there is no data set. So let me understand this thing. I declare one local variable, that is dim I as integer, then this I will accept e dot row index. My friends, this are the particular rows will show in my data grid view. It may be possible I can select any of this row when I want to update the record. So let me move to our main code. Yes, e dot row index will come to I, then dim j as data grid view row. This is a particular part where j will store as a data grid view row, and then after j equal to data grid view 1 dot rows of I. So friends, it is very simple and sober thing that I want to put it down in a comment like that. By this code, our product ID will bind with label 8 when we click data grid view. So understand this thing, this is a comment line. By this particular comment line you can understand what is the meaning for next all this 7 line. Textbook 7.txt, same thing will be there. Yes, if you want to use not J but you want to use it data grid view, then you can use also, but your code will be changed by data grid view 1 of I dot cell and all. But here I can make it this code very easy for you. J will represent data grid view row, and this particular J is using data grid view 1 dot rows of I. Means whatever the row you are using, that particular code will come to there, and instead of this J, if you will use the same code anywhere of this, it will work. So friends, let me understand this thing again, because it is very important. And for update and delete query, this is must. So any record that you want to update, any record that you want to delete, this data grid view cell content click event is very important. So again, button 1 dot enable equal to false. Let me check, this is my button 1. Yes. So what it is there, if I will be make it this enable false, you cannot add this duplicate record. So I'm making this comment for you guys by this process, our add button will disable, so we can't add the same record. Then after button 2 dot enable equal to true, button 3 dot enable equal to true, that we need it because button 2 is used for update the record. This button 3 used for delete the record. And yes, radio button 1 dot visible true. When we execute this particular part, let me make it this comment. And whenever we run this particular project, you will understand this thing very clearly. So let me take a run, execute this project by F5 or press the symbol. This project is executing. It will throw me that login part that you know very well. The login is abhi@gmail.com. It's a admin login, and I'm entering the password. When I click on login, it will show me it means the password should be changed or must change. So let me stop the project, and we are going to employee detail, show table data, and into show table data @abhijeet.gmail.com. and yes, the password is Kinjal, abhijeet@gmail.com. Entering the password, user found admin, the previous type mistake was there and forgot the password, so I just go to the database and take a reference about it. When I click there, you know that one, we are understanding the product. I click on insert product, this particular form is maximized, and yes, when I click anywhere of this, look, yes, this code is started. And let me understand about it, how this code is work. It is very exciting to understand this thing very well. I press F11, I have use I, and when I put it over here at I, you can understand that when I'm putting 3 over here, 0 1 2 3, I click on actually 4 record, but whenever the data grid view 1 will load the event, your first record will take as a 0, like an error. So move to the code, F11 is there, and F11 is there. Look, this is 4, and you guys know that is 4. Which product is there? Just a wait. And by this text box 1 is bathing shop, then after the life boy, and it is not move yet, but when I press F11, now you put a cursor, lemon fresh. And by this particular way, F11, your add button will definitely enable false, so you cannot add the record. This record will not add because this record is already existing. Button 3 is enabled. This is a delete button. Radio button is visible. And yes, students, in front of you when I click on this data grid view, your related product is available by this particular code. This is a fourth number. And let me do one more thing that is very important for this. 125 gram lemon fresh soap is there, and I want to reduce the price of it because I have overstock of it. It may be possible sometimes some shop owners is having overstock about some product, so they can reduce the price. When I click on update, yes, I move to this update code. That was 2 is nothing. Yes, connection will open. This update query will perform. Execute none query will be there. Message box 1 record will update. Look, it will be available. 1 record updated. CN close is there. NDF is there. All record is there. And NDF is there. Then after, again, all record subroutine will load. Connection adapter will pick up all the record. Previously the price was 62 rupees, my friends, and now I updated. So data adapter adapt the records, data set is declared, data adapter will fill this record to the data set, and finally data grid v1.data source equal to ds.tables, the table name is pdet, connection close. Yes, my friends, you look at over there, I come to the code again, because here the 62 is there and 57 is there. So I think that F11 must be there. Yes, look at over here, previously it was 62, now it is 57. For same thing, if you want to delete any product, yes, I want to delete Dairy Milk, this particular product. I select F11. This loading is there, it is binding is there, each button 1 dot enable false, so I cannot add the duplicate record. Update will available, delete will available, radio button will be available. And look at over here, confectionery, the company name is Cadbury Dairy Milk Shorts, 16.2 grams. The price is 42 and product quantity is only 2. I cannot add this product because this button is enable false, so no chance to add this duplicate record, no problem. My click on delete record. Yes, students, my friends, understand the same code like update. Textbox 1.txt, nothing. Yes, it is their record, so connection will open. Delete query will perform. CMD.execute none query will use for insert, update and delete the record. It's a common thing. Message box 1 record will be deleted. Connection closes there. The message will available and my front and connection close. After that end if, all record will there and all record open, adapter will go there. I already delete 1 record. Let me take a look. It's really simple to understand the code. All record will return and some will return, and you can understand that one. The 6th number record will deleted from this, and it's a very simple way. Insert record is as it is, that you know very well. After this, let me stop this thing. I break up point, I close it, and when I click on it, show table data is there. And when I click on it, oh my god, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 number record, that Dairy Milk Shorts is not available. Along with this, you can see that bathing shop, that Life Boy, previously the price was 62 rupees, now it is 57. So thank you very much guys to make with me about learning and understanding the concept of add, update, delete and coding by this. This thing you know very well, this is a searching process. My textbox 7 change, data adapter will be there, select star from product details, a table, product full name like, and when you use a like operator, like keyword, you have to use a percentage operator, first and second both, and whatever the product particular full name will be typed by you, it will be adapt, data set declare, data adapter, fill that particular records to data set, and it will be immediately effect to the data grid. So very easy, fun to understand. Let me execute once more. Admin is there. Go to the product, insert, update, delete, and search. I come there, and yes, product full name having a D in this sandal, D is there, dairy milk having a this. And if I use M, I look, so very easy to understand. Lux cooling mint, MI is there. Dairy milk, MI is there. But this is the change that I want to show you. When I press MIL, then only three products are there. Previously there are four, because in mint MI N is there, and when I use MIL, I have only three records: dairy milk silk 6 gram, dairy milk silk leakable 20 grams, milliliter, and MILI. This is the only one product that we have. When I move backspace, all record will load. Thank you to watching this particular product adding video for project development as a part of it. Thank you so much, guys, to being with me. Thanks a lot.